Okay, Pops, we are going to have a fun episode today. We're going to talk about car search websites and how they make money. Last time I checked, if you're going to find a car to buy, you have to start online. But the process of like becoming a lead online to like buying a car at a dealership, it's pretty interesting. I thought we kind of peel the curtain back on all that. And yeah, part of the reason we're doing it is because now you can search for cars on our website, joinyaa.com.
Okay. Where do you want me to start?
Let's kick things off with that from the consumer perspective. Then you can kind of shed the light on how these things work from the dealership perspective. If I go to like name a car search website, not ours, name a car search website.
Autotrader.com.
If I go to autotrader.com, yeah. I'm greeted with millions of cars for sale, whatever, all the filters, everything I can find. The way that they make money is like the sponsored listings, right? Like that's got to be one piece. And like I imagine those lead gen forms. Like, is their business model any more complex than that?
Well, the only other complexity to it would be the other advertising they sell within the website to like manufacturers and things like that.
But oh, like you mean like the banner ads and stuff like that?
The banner ads, yes. But the dealerships pay Auto Trader to get to have their car show up in a good spot on a good page. You know, everybody will tell you that if you want something to be seen on the internet, it better pop up on page one, because well, most people are never getting to page two, and if yours shows up on page four, well, then what was the point? So yeah. They sell sponsorships. They sell the ability to have your cars show up on the first page or in the first five listings and things like that. And then they also sell the leads on whatever particular cars to the dealerships.
And then on the dealership side of things, like how does that work? Do you have, when you used to work, your most recent job was at the Mini dealership when you were managing that. Did you guys work directly with Auto Trader, or did you have like a marketing agency? Like how did it work from your end?
They have you know, every one of these like Car Gurus and Auto Trader and Carfax, they all have individual.
You forgot Car GG. I love Car GG.
You know, I never dealt with Car GG. Thank God for that. But they all have independent reps that go around and service a particular marketing area. And so you'd have a rep. Now, when I worked at the Mini dealership, you know, we were part of a larger local group. So we actually had a marketing representative that they would deal with. Then we were told, okay, we need to get X number of cars available to go on, you know, the particular website. And so then we would, you know, we would go out, shoot the cars with a camera. Okay. And then the next thing you know, they'd be appearing on whatever website we were using.
Now other websites. So that's like your traditional listings, like Auto Trader, Car Gurus, et cetera. And yeah. So like as consumers, we all get access to those for free, but then obviously like there's the ads and yes. There's the sponsored listings. Okay, great. Got it. They don't get paid. Do they get paid on like a per lead basis? Like when I fill out that
no.
form request? Okay. The only one that comes to mind for me who did used to do that model is TrueCar, which
yes.
TrueCar used to do, if you like became a TrueCar lead, then they charge the dealership a certain amount of money or something like that.
If you subscribed as a dealership to TrueCar.
And did you ever work for dealerships that did subscribe
yes,
to TrueCar?
And you were affiliated with TrueCar. So if they sent you a lead and you sold that person a car, if it was a new car, you were expected to remit $299 to TrueCar for that sold lead. And it was $399, if I remember correctly, for a sold pre-owned car lead. That was how that worked. The unfortunate reality is that violated laws in many states about paying somebody to refer a customer to you. And then the other issue was, well, what if the people had been on our own website first, saw the car there, sent in a lead requesting information, and also we got a lead from TrueCar? Well, then you had to argue which had the earlier timestamp, and you'd have to fight back and forth. Well, I won't pay you for this lead, but we'll pay you for that lead. And then ultimately, TrueCar had to change their business practices to where they would just charge you a monthly fee for being a true car member. And if I remember correctly, the fee at that time when they went over to that was, I think, $1,599 a month.
So then the other category of like online car site that I think is worth bringing up are like the trade tools, like KBB comes to mind for me. Like what are the other, are there other ones? Edmunds, I guess, is like the other one that's pretty frequently
used. There's a bunch of them that do it. And yeah, the whole idea there is to collect as much vehicle and customer information as you can, and then farm it out to dealers who have agreed to either participate in this program with the, and there the dealership hope is that, well, you're the dealership that they select to where you're going to sell the car. But even if you don't, they can stay in contact with you to find out what you're doing and do their best to try and get you into their dealership to either buy your existing car or to sell you another car.
So then let's flip the script here a little bit. Obviously, what we're doing back on our website, Pops, we have no dealer affiliation. So like there is no sponsored listings. There are no ads and there are no lead gen forms. So there's no you can't contact the dealership directly through YAA. You can use our email templates. You can copy the email templates, but you can't just like fill out a form and contact a dealership. And that like those are very intentional decisions. Put you on the spot here for a second. Yes. What do you think the future of this process looks like? Like, you know, we've got listings websites where you can search through millions of cars. You can search through millions of cars on our website.
Yes.
To me, it feels a little like, like I don't want to search through millions. Just like tell me which car I want or what, like tell me which car I should get. How do you think about this business model moving forward?
Well, I would think that a listing website that can provide information above and beyond just the car that you're looking at. I would think the future would be a website that not only provides that, but provides other insights as well as to what the market conditions are for that particular vehicle in that particular part of the country, what the day supply is, how many have been sold, similar vehicles have been sold in the last 90 days or whatever. And then also provides advice as to how to perhaps contact the dealer if you're interested in that car, or how to perhaps negotiate better pricing for that, tips along those lines at no additional charge as well. I think that once it catches on will be the future of listings, you know, because that type of website actually don't shoot the messenger, actually helps the consumer as opposed to helping the dealership.
It adds a little value to the process. But, you know, I got to give Car Gurus some credit here because I think they're doing something that kind of speaks to the future of this as well. As much of the transaction that can take place online, the better. So, for example, on Car Gurus, they now have like ways that you can get pre-qualified for your loan directly in Car Gurus, which I think is really impressive. You know, you're dependent on who they have relationships with, of course. But like, I think a push towards more and more of the stuff that currently takes place at the dealership will start to take place on these websites. Car Gurus is at the forefront of it. I think Auto Trader and the other ones that are owned by Cox Automotive, like they're going to stay a little bit further back behind because they're so bureaucratic and their business models are so entrenched in how they currently do things. But yeah, we're super thrilled with what we have. We make money when you sign up to become a premium member. So that's like you pay us. We don't get paid by anyone else except for you. So check it out back on the website. Everything's free that we talked about here today. It's just interesting to think about how this market works, how it works from the customer standpoint, from the dealership standpoint, and how we're trying to like position ourselves in there.
Yes, I couldn't agree more. It's only because it fits into our mantra of trying to advocate for consumers. And I think that is the most beneficial aspect of our listings page.
How can people access it, Pops? What's the URL?
I believe you'd go to something like www, and I understand you don't need to type in the www, join YAA.com. And the home page will give you the opportunity to go directly to listings, or if you already have a car and you're not interested in looking for a new car, but you're interested in perhaps some protection products for it, like a vehicle service contract, you could click on that tab.
You got there, buddy. You got there.
Yeah. I'm sorry. I'm wordy.